Hey Ross, where my money makes money. PMI, primary monthly installment. No, I'm kidding. Private mortgage insurance. Private mortgage insurance. Do you know what that is? So it's an insurance for the bank or whatever lender gave you the money to buy your home. They saying, well, you have to pay this an additional amount of insurance because we're not going to pay it, but you need to pay it. And this is mainly on conventional loans, not your FHAs. Now, in order to avoid private mortgage insurance, you need to put down 20% of your home price. 20% can alleviate primary, I keep saying primary, 20% can alleviate private mortgage insurance. So I'm gonna go over to bank rate and I'm just gonna throw this up so you guys follow me as I read this through. So again, here you go. What is private mortgage insurance? Private mortgage insurance is a type of insurance you may be required to pay for when you take out a conventional home loan. Okay, so that's it in a nutshell. Now, should you avoid PMI? PMI is a layer of protection for lenders, but an added expense for you as a borrower. So this is talking about you as a borrower. Conventional loans are the most popular type of mortgages, but they're also the one that isn't insured by the government. Once you pay 20% of your home's loan-to-value ratio, you can contact your lender about removing PMI from your mortgage payment. Keep in mind that PMI doesn't go away automatically. You must request it. It does not go away automatically. Now, here are some ways to avoid PMI. You put 20% down. You put 20% down. That should alleviate and have them to remove it once you request it. Consider an FHA loan. The minimum down payment for an FHA loan is only 3.5%. This is a good option if you have less than stellar credit, but the closing process could take a little longer with this option, and FHA loans have higher fees. Now, cancel PMI later. If you couldn't get out of a private mortgage insurance when you bought your home, keep track of your payments. Once the loan balance reaches 80% of the home's value, 80%, you can ask the lender to drop the mortgage insurance premiums. Now, you'll wonder, well, how much PMI cost? PMI is typically an annual premium of 0.05% to 1% of the original loan amount per year, depending on the size of the down payment and your credit score. So for example, if the home price is $200,000 and your PMI is 1%, you're going to pay $2,000 a year or a bit more than $166 a month. You're paying $2,000 a year extra on a $200,000 home. So that's what PMI really is. So monthly, most PMI policies require you to make monthly payments. This is an additional charge added onto your monthly mortgage bill. One larger payment sometimes lender required to be paid in full at the time of closing. You can see if yours does in your loan estimate. Now both, sort of like a down payment, you may be able to pay some of your PMI upfront and the rest in your monthly mortgage payment. Mortgage insurance paid in 2018 is tax deductible under the Tax Cuts and Jobs Act. So, if you want to avoid an extra $166 a month or an extra $2,000 on your home and you do the math, your down payment must be 20% or more to alleviate PMI because they're trying to really protect their asset because you bought the home, they gave you the money for the home, but it's still their home. And until you pay off your loan, they wanna make sure, because this private mortgage insurance is simply protecting them. If you can't afford it in the end, something happens and you can't pay your mortgage from the home going into foreclosure so they can recoup some of the money. Yeah, they're insuring their home because you bought a new home, but it's actually theirs. It's like your car. If you don't pay off your car, it's not yours, because you know how they remind you? They repossess it. You know how they remind you? They foreclose on your home, but it's never really yours until you have the lease, the deed, and you know what I mean. This is Ross World. Learn money and be inspired. Avoid PMI. Maybe you can get an FHA loan, and maybe you can put 10% down, so your fees are a little lower when you do an FHA loan. But if you get a conventional loan, try to pay more than 20% of that home. You might have to save a year or two to avoid it, but in the end, you will come out saving thousands of dollars a year, because who really knows how long it's gonna take you to pay down 20% of the current value of your home to avoid PMI. I'm out.